Hello, family and friends. It's your friendly firearms pastor, TRUEXODUS, coming at you today to share with you two very different SIG 229s. You've got the Elite and the Legion. Which one is better? If you had to buy one, which would it be? Can't wait to tell you all about it. Now, if you've yet to subscribe to this channel, please do so. Turn on the notifications, give us a like, join us in the comment section below. It makes Jesus very, very happy and Satan very, very sad when preachers are talking about pistols. I don't know if that's true or not, but it sounded nice. Oh, I have a lot of history with this gun. In fact, the first gun I ever owned was a SIG 226 chambered 9mm, but my best friend in Bible college convinced me because he had an XD in chambered in 40 caliber. He said, you can't shoot anybody with a 9. You have to have 40 for more knockdown power. So believe it or not, I traded in that 226. I traded in that 226, got a 229 chambered in 40, shot the heck out of that gun, absolutely loved it, and then traded in for a USP. Never trade in a gun to a gun store. You'll get ripped off, but that's neither here nor there. Now, fast forwarding to today, we've got the Elite and the Legion. If you only had to spend money on one of them, which one would you buy and why? That's what we seek to answer today in our video. But what you need to understand is that SIG sent me both of these. I've got about 4,000 rounds through the Elite, and I've got about 2,000 rounds through the Legion. So I've spent a lot more time with the Elite, about double as much as I have with the Legion. There's things that I like, there's things that I don't like, so let's hop into it. Now, when it comes to carry guns, I really feel like it could be broken down into three categories. You've got shootability, reliability, and price. The price of these guns is a little expensive. Insert rail scales comment here. Anyway, the Elite comes in at right at $1,000. You could find it anywhere between $950 to, you know, $1,050, somewhere around there. And then the Legion comes in about $1,200. I don't know what you're paying for. We'll get into that in a second. In terms of reliability, anybody who's ever shot the 229 platform extensively will tell you that reliability is not a thing for the 229. It is so on point when it comes to when you press the trigger, this gun will go bang. And not only is the gun reliable, but the magazines are really reliable and good as well. Never had any issues with that. The Elite, I put through the sand, dirt, and water test, passed with flying colors. The Legion, I have not done that with, so please forgive me. But when we talk about the shootability of these two different guns, well, that's a different story. Slight variations between the recoil impulses of what you're gonna get from the Legion and the Elite. Now, shootability is a word that I'm pretty sure I wordsmithed. And basically, when I say shootability, I'm asking the question, how well does the gun aid the shooter in applying the fundamentals of grip, sight picture, and of course, trigger pull? Now, I know that we're talking about preference for sure, but as an instructor who's been instructing people for about 10 years now on the line, I have found that there are guns that help people shoot well, and there are guns that do not help people shoot well. And there's some general differences and similarities between guns that aid the shooters and guns that just don't aid them at all. But when it comes to the Elite specifically, I really do like the grip. The grip is kind of this wavy, platformy kind of thing, and it feels really good in the hand. I have smaller hands, while as the Legion is a little bit fatter, it's a little bit meatier. Now, I do like the master grip on the Legion more than I like the Elite, so check one for the Legion. The Legion also has this little check ring put underneath the trigger guard, and let me tell you, when I get this master grip and this sets in just like that, I like the feel of that way more than the non-checkered pattern of the Elite. Now, both guns have two very different sight pictures. The Elite has the traditional three-dot night sight, combat sight picture that SIG is known for on their older pistols, but now they're starting to switch towards these more X-ray sights where you've got the pronounced eco-friendly green sight and the kind of blacked out-ish rear sights, I guess not to convolute kind of the information that your brain is receiving. I have yet to receive the RX, which is the optic ready version that they're putting upon the 229. I cannot wait to get that from SIG. So hopefully we can do another video, because that is going to be probably my choice of 229s, neither here nor there. Now, while the 229 triggers feel identical as far as double action and single action pull, the triggers themselves feel a little bit different on the fingers. The Elite feels fatter. It feels like there's more surface area. It's the traditional curve trigger. The Legion feels like it is a traditional curve trigger as well. It's just there's less surface area for the finger pad to go on. That's going to be personal preference for you right there. I find that I shoot a little bit more accurately the Elite than I do the Legion, and I think it's got everything to do with the surface area of the trigger. Is there a difference between the recoil impulse of the two guns? There actually is. There is a softer recoil impulse in the Elite than in the Legion, and I think it's got everything to do with the beaver tail. This beaver tail is a lot more pronounced than this one, as you can see, and while I prefer a smaller beaver tail, I prefer the shooting experience of the Elite over the Legion. So while yes, this beaver tail is bigger, it actually gets in the way of my draw. When I appendix carry this and I go to make that purchase, I like to have my thumb trying to drape across the backsight. I think that that helps me align my finger with the slide a little bit better and allows for a better grip as I come around with both hands at marriage position. The Legion doesn't have a very big beaver tail, so it's a lot easier to get a good master grip on it and come out of the holster. I'm actually a little bit faster with the Legion than I am with the Elite. Nine, seven. Let's try that again. Nine, two. All right, so we're doing the Legion now with the fit loader stop. 2 to 9 from 3 yards. 2 to the pelvis, 2 to the chest, 1 to the face, and under 2.5. At 182. So just gonna slow down the pace a little bit, I guess. Seems as though I should just do my normal pace. I'll do my normal. We're at 175. Now, on the topic of carrying the pistols, the Elite is a lot easier to use in manipulations. The mag release is pretty much the same on both of the pistols, but what's different, what's noticeably different, are the decocker and the slide release. The decocker is a little bit easier to manipulate and reach on the Elite because it's a little bit bigger on the Elite than it is on the Legion. When it comes to inserting a mag and releasing the slide release, it's a lot easier to do with the Elite than with the Legion, 100%. This thing is so small, it's tiny. So when I go to insert the mag and I go to press it with my thumb, I never am able to send the slide home without adjusting my grip in some way, shape, or form. That being said, because of my master grip that I have, it's a lot higher upon the gun, and so my thumb, my meaty part of my thumb, always holds the slide release down, meaning that the gun doesn't lock back in the last round. Ever? Never does. The Legion, on the other hand, will. So there's some pros and some cons. I know a lot of you old school guys are gonna be like, well, you just gotta rack it back like you're petting a dog. And that is most certainly what I do with the Legion. But I also like using the slide release because it's just faster. You know, you get the magazine in and you hammer it home. It's a lot harder to do with the Legion than it is with the Elite. Yeah, there's a couple of ways you can release the slide. You can do it via you know, their thumb coming in like you do with the 1911 guys. You can pet the dog, or you can simply just do it how it's supposed to be done, you know, whichever. Look, I'm getting stronger. Alrighty then, the moment of truth. If you could only spend money on one, if you could only carry one, if you could only pick up one, which one would it be and why? I'm gonna say about 54 times out of 100, I'm gonna go with the Elite over the Legion, and here's why. I don't see where the extra $200 is going into the Legion. And if you can find an Elite under $1,000, even if you can find one used, you're gonna be so much better off spending that extra money on training and on ammo and finding a quality instructor, unlike myself, I'm not quality, than you would then spending the extra $200 or $300 you would on the Legion. I just don't see it from the Legion, so we're just gonna leave that be that, and we're gonna say, Elite, thank you for being the SIG Enhanced Elite 229. Guys, we thank you so much for joining us in this time. I hope I didn't ruffle too many feathers with that. Go ahead and leave a comment in the comment section below. Let me know how crazy I am. Let me know if I'm off my meds, but I think that the Elite is way better. Not way better. Like I said, 54 times, 55, maybe 57 times out of 100, I'm gonna pick the Elite over the Legion. Guys, thanks so much for tuning in. Join us next time as we talk about the Vortex Micro x3 red dot magnifier, flip to the side, piece of crap, or is it? We'll talk about that next time. It's at this point in the video that I want to remind us that I make these videos so that you can be a well-informed, researched purchaser, not an impulse buyer. So don't just take my word for it. Go around, look at what other people have to say, and make the most informed purchase that you can. I get all this crap for free. In fact, I was flying back from Honduras in 2015. I had 20,000, 25,000 Instagram followers, and the Holy Spirit doesn't speak to me very often, but when he does, it's alarming. It's the most clearest, most resounding thing that you've heard inside your inner being, and you know it's not from yourself, because I was in a plane when God said to me, I don't want you to spend any more money on guns and ammo. And I'm like, say what? No more money on guns and ammo? And I thought about that. It was such a foreign concept, foreign thought. I was just like, is that a command from the Lord? Because it feels like a command from the Lord. The next day that I would confirm and say in my heart of hearts, God, I'm not going to spend any more money on guns and ammo. That very next day, my first ammo sponsor called me and said, we want to give you all of your bullets to shoot. And I was like, oh my gosh, what? That's insane. So ever since then, I've been obedient to God in that there are some things that I will save up for. Not very many things, because I like putting my money towards other things. So please, would you be a good steward of the resources that God has blessed you with and make informed purchases and not impulse buys? Your wife will thank me later. Now, if you haven't figured out already, I leverage social media and shooting for the gospel of Jesus Christ. I want you to know about the great God of the universe, the only God of the universe that loves you. He loves you so much that he sent his son Jesus to die upon the cross for you, for your individual sins, so that you would not have to bear the wrath of God on Judgment Day, which is coming, that you would not have to spend an eternity in hell in the burning lake of fire that Satan and all of his angels and all those who practice lawlessness and wickedness are going. They are going there. It is a sure done deal. There's good and there's evil. I know that you know it, and I know that you believe it in the world. I'm telling you right now that if you have yet to confess to Jesus as Lord and Master and Savior of your life, if you have yet to submit to him in the waters of baptism, if you have yet to begin your journey of discipleship and of apprenticeship towards him, following after him each and every day, if Jesus is not the highlight of your life, he most certainly needs to be, because the Bible's very clear. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Bible says in Acts chapter 4, verse 12, there is no other name on heaven and earth by which men can be saved except for the name of Jesus Christ. So guys, if you're looking for somebody to reach out to, if you want somebody to counsel you and to develop you, or to just kind of point you towards some authors or some good books or something, anything to get you going towards reading your Bibles and reaching out and praying to God, I am most certainly willing to assist you in that. So please reach out to me. That's why I'm here. I give myself to you all freely. And that's all I have to say in this video. TRUEXODUS saying, hold fast to the course. Out.